Okay, so have you ever really stopped to think about where money comes from? I mean, really comes from. It's not just about the government printing presses, not by a long shot. Most of the money in our economy is actually created every single day right inside the banks we use. And today, we're going to pull back that curtain and see exactly how it's done.
So that brings us to the big question, right? Can banks just create money out of thin air? It sounds a little crazy, maybe even like something out of a conspiracy theory. But believe it or not, it's pretty much the core of how modern banking works. And to really get how, we've got to start with the foundation.
Right. So before we can watch money multiply, which is the exciting part, we have to understand what it's built on. Think of it like the raw material for the entire financial system. And that raw material has a name, the money base.
So what exactly is the money base? Well, you can think of it as the total, fundamental amount of money that a central bank has put out there. It's really just two things: the physical cash you might have in your pocket, plus the reserves that regular banks, you know, commercial banks, hold at the central bank. It is the absolute bedrock of everything else we're about to talk about.
Let's actually put some numbers on this to make it real. Let's just imagine that our entire economy's money base is a nice round 1,000. Now, of that 1,000, let's say 400 of it is physical cash floating around in public, and the other 600 is what the banks are holding as reserves. Got it? 400 and 600. Keep those numbers in your head, because that's our starting point.
Okay, so we've got our money base of $1,000 all set up. Now, let's take a quick snapshot of the economy before anything changes. But to do that, we need to introduce one more super important rule that all the banks have to follow.
And that rule is called the reserve ratio. This is a big one. It's basically a regulation that the central bank sets, and it tells all the other banks what fraction, what percentage of their customer deposits they absolutely must keep on hand. They have to hold it in reserve. They're not allowed to lend this part out. It's a really critical lever of control for the whole system.
So for our starting scenario, our little economy here, let's just say the central bank has set this ratio at 25%. What does that actually mean? Well, it means for every $100 that you or I deposit, the bank has to hold on to 25 of those dollars. The other 75, they're free to lend that out.
Okay, so here's what the bank's books look like at this point. We already know their reserves are 600, right? And because the rules say this 600 has to be 25% of all their deposits, we can actually work backward. It tells us that the total deposits must be 2,400. And if that's the case, it means the rest, the other 1,800, has been loaned out. See how that works? Assets and liabilities. Everything is perfectly balanced. This is our stable before picture.
Now, this is where we have to make a really, really important distinction. The money supply is not the same thing as the money base. The money supply is bigger. It's all that cash held by the public, plus all those checking account deposits sitting in the banking system. It's basically the money that's ready and available for all of us to spend.
So now we can finally figure out the total money supply in our little economy. We just take that 400 in cash that's out there in people's hands, and we add the 2,400 in bank deposits we just calculated. And that gives us a starting money supply of 2,800. This is our baseline. Remember that number.
All right, now for the action. Our nice, stable economy is about to get a pretty big jolt. The central bank decides it's time to make one single policy change. Just one little move that's going to trigger a powerful chain reaction through the entire financial system.
And what's their big move? It's actually pretty simple. They're going to lower the reserve ratio. The central bank just decides that banks don't need to hold as much cash anymore for every dollar that gets deposited. And this one little administrative change, well, it's about to unleash a huge wave of new money.
Let's just see how big of a change this is. The ratio drops from 25% all the way down to just 10%. Think about that. Now banks only have to hold on to $10 for every 100 deposited. That frees up a ton more money to be lent out into the economy.
Okay, now listen closely, because this is the most important and maybe the most counterintuitive part of this whole thing. Even though the rules just changed, the actual money base, that bedrock we talked about, has not changed, not one bit. There is still only 400 in cash out there, and still only 600 in bank reserves. That amount is fixed. If you get this one point, the rest all clicks into place.
Okay, so with that key rule in our minds, that the money base is constant, we can now just sit back and watch the dominoes fall. Let's trace exactly how this one simple rule change causes the bank's balance sheets to just expand like crazy.
And you know what? The math here is actually surprisingly simple. We start with our bank reserves, which we know haven't changed. They're still 600. But now that 600 only represents 10% of total deposits. So what do? We divide that 600 by the new ratio, 0.1, and boom. Suddenly the total deposits supported by those exact same reserves just ballooned to 6,000.
And here it is, the brand new balance sheet. Just look at that thing. The reserves, they're still 600. That didn't change. But now they're backing up 6,000 in deposits. And to make it all balance out, the banks have now been able to create a massive 5,400 in brand new loans. All because one little rule changed.
All right. We've seen the mechanics. We've watched the balance sheet explode. And now it is time for the big reveal. Let's calculate the new total money supply in our transformed economy.
So what's our new grand total? We use the exact same formula as before. We take the new deposit amount, which is 6,000, and we add that 400 in cash that's been there the whole time. The new money supply is 6,400.
And here it is. This is the real aha moment. Just look at this comparison. We started with a money supply of 2,800. And after the central bank did nothing more than change a rule on a piece of paper, the money supply has now exploded to 6,400. The amount of spendable money in the economy just more than doubled.
And that's the bottom line right there. A total of 3,600 in new money was just created, and not by printing a single bill, but just by changing the rules of lending. This new money exists as digital deposits and loans created by the banking system itself.
So what are the big takeaways here? What should you really remember from all this? Well, first, the money base and the money supply are two totally different beasts. Second, commercial banks really, truly do create money, not by printing it, but through the simple act of lending. And finally, a central bank has this incredible power to expand the money supply just by tweaking that little number, the reserve ratio.
Of course, this leaves us with a pretty huge question, doesn't it? If banks can create money just like this, what's to stop them from creating an infinite amount and causing total chaos? Well, the answer to that involves things like central bank controls, economic demand, and the ever-present risk of bank runs. But that, my friends, is a story for a whole other day.